sessions? Okay, so today's session we are going to begin with lesson number 10, motion and measurement of distances. You all are already aware what is measurement and why measurement is so important in our life. So our today's topic will be only measurement. What is measurement? Why do we need to measure things? And what things help us to measure? Okay, so let's move on. So children, today's topic is measurement. Now what is measurement? It is comparison of an unknown quantity with a known fixed quantity. What do you mean by comparison? Comparison means I have two things and I am going to compare them, right? Suppose I have one line segment, right? This is one line segment A and B. I have another line segment C and D. Now, just by looking at these two line segments, you can easily tell that which one is short and which one is longer, right? But can you tell me exactly what is the length of this line segment? No, isn't it? We cannot tell exactly what is the length. So here comes the use of measurement. We make use of a scale. Now this scale will help me to find the length of line segment AB and the length of line segment CD. So what is line segment AB? Line segment AB is unknown quantity. Unknown, I don't know, right? And what is this scale? This scale is a fixed quantity. It is fixed. I know what is the length. And that is how we are able to measure the length of line segment. Even the same thing we are doing when we go to buy clothes. Isn't it? They use a meter rod. When you go to the tailor, he takes your measurement using a measuring tape. So, measurement is very, very important. And how we measure things is by using some fixed quantity. Now, what is this fixed quantity actually called? It is called as a unit. So, what is a unit? A unit is a fixed quantity when we are measuring things. Right? Now, my second point is, what are the parts of measurement? Now, children, suppose the length of this line is, line segment is 3 centimeters. So, can you see that I have written two things over here, 3 centimeters. So, what is 3? 3 is the number and centimeter is the unit. But if I write that what is the length of line segment AB, if I just write 3, will it be correct? No, because I have not mentioned the unit. So for measurement we have to write two things. Number one is the number and second is the unit. So 3 centimeter is the correct answer, right? Suppose the length of this line segment is 6. Am I correct? No, because I have not written the unit. So I will say it is 6 centimeter. So you measure any object. You buy apples. You will say I want 2 kg apples. So 2 is the number, kg is the unit. Or when your father brings oil at home, the edible oil, it is 5 liters. 5 is the number, liters is the unit. Got it? So you all know what is measurement and what are the parts of measurement, right? You have done this thing in maths also. Now comes distance. What is distance? between two points. Suppose this is your home and this is your school. So in between these two points we call it distance, or we can also call it length, right? Now what things make our work easier to measure length? It is the scale. And what is the advantage of using a scale? A scale can be taken from one place to another easily, isn't it? You come to school, you bring your scale with you. You can carry the scale anywhere. We can carry the measuring tape anywhere. So this is the benefit of using a scale. Secondly, the readings on the scale will never change. My next topic is need for standard scale. Now you have already done in class 5. You have done standard scale, or you remember we did standard units? Yes. Now why do we need a standard unit, or why do we need a fixed unit? So let's get back to our class 5. You remember that in class 5 we discussed that in earlier days people used their body parts, isn't it? They used their body parts to measure the length of things. You must have seen your grandmother, isn't it? They use their palm. What do we call this? From your thumb to the little finger, we call it as hand span. Yes? So they use this. Or you must have seen the shopkeepers also, or your grannies, when they measure the length of cloth, they put it on the nose and then they measure it like this. So they all were using their body parts. So they were using their palm, they were using their foot length, they were using their arm length. Yes? So what, when we use our palm, we call it as hand span. When we use our foot length, we call it as foot length. When we use our arm length, arm means from my elbow to this finger, right? What do we call it? We call it cubit. One more thing you have learned in class 5 was fathom, the length of outstretched arms. Means from this point to this point, what is the length? That is called fathom. But do you think it is the same with every person? No, isn't it? If a small child comes and you are standing and you both stretch your arms, will the length be the same? No, isn't it? So there will be a lot of confusion that you say one hand span or two hand span. Now your palm and your friend's palm both have different size. So there will be a lot of confusion. It will not be the same. So to avoid this confusion and to have accurate measurement, we use standard units, right? So what are the standard units? You already know. You have done that in mathematics also. The standard units of length, standard units of mass, and standard units of capacity, which we will be covering in our next video. Till then, goodbye. See you.